Cityscapes are stunning visualizations of locations that not only help you create memories, but also make great gifts. In today's video, I'll show you how to create a cityscape of any location using free software and publicly available data. We'll use two different techniques for creating cityscapes in this video. The first technique is great for creating flat cityscapes with little elevation. I've used this technique for creating cityscapes of the National Mall in Washington, D.C., the White House, and the Eiffel Tower in Paris, France. The second technique is great for cityscapes with a lot of elevation in the terrain. I use this technique to create a cityscape of Mammoth Ski Resort in California and the Peak in Hong Kong. Let's get started. Here's the game plan for the flat cityscapes. We'll use a program called CADmapper to generate 2D drawings of the location we want. Then we'll split the drawing into layers in a 2D graphics editor like Inkscape or Adobe Illustrator. Then we'll import those layers into Fusion 360, where we will extrude the 2D drawings into 3D models. CADmapper is a program that uses publicly available data from programs like OpenStreetMap to create CAD drawings of these places. Create a free account, and then you'll be greeted by the main interface. There's some options for the type of drawing and other features on the left and a map on the right. We'll be using the Adobe Illustrator export option, but there's other options for exporting as well. CADmapper lets you create drawings up to 1 kilometer squared for free, and then you can purchase files that are bigger than 1 kilometer squared. You can search for any location in the search bar. Let's start with creating a map of Times Square in New York City. To select a location, click and drag to create a rectangle. The indicator in the bottom will tell you how big the map is. I suggest starting with a smaller map just so you can get the hang of this process. Once you're satisfied, click Create File to create the map. It'll show a preview on the next screen. Assuming you're satisfied, click to download the zip file, then go ahead and unzip it. Next, we'll use a graphics program like Adobe Illustrator or Inkscape. Inkscape is a free option to convert the drawing into layers. You can download Inkscape for free, or you can get a free trial of Adobe Creative Cloud to use Illustrator. In the graphics program, create a new file and change the units from pixels to millimeters and set the size of the file to the size of your build plate. Import the SVG and then adjust the size so it fits within the file size. Next, we'll want to split this up into layers. Click the menu in the top right to create a new layer. We'll name the first one Buildings. Then we'll drag the buildings into the buildings layer. We'll continue this process for all of the features in our set. You can delete the one called Contours, as that one's unnecessary. Now we'll export everything as a DXF. Click File, Export As. Under Format, select DXF. Click OK to accept the default settings. Next, we'll be using Fusion 360. If you don't already have it, you can download the free Maker version from the Autodesk website. Now import the DXF file into Fusion 360. Click Insert DXF and make sure to select one sketch per file. First, start a new sketch on the top plane. Click R to draw a rectangle that encloses our map. Now click E on your keyboard to start an extrusion, and I'll enter -1 to extrude it down 1 millimeter. Now we'll start extruding each feature one by one. Click Sketches in the browser to reveal the dropdown, and then let's hide every sketch except for the roads. Zoom in and click the closed off area of the roads. Click E again to extrude. I have occasionally found that the roads aren't closed off on some of the exported drawings from CADmapper. If you run into this issue, try reselecting the area in CADmapper and seeing if that version of the roads will extrude. I'll extrude the roads up 4 millimeters, but it can be really any height. I'll make sure it's creating a new body so it's easy to use for multicolor printing later. And I'll give it some color in Fusion 360 just so it's easy to see visually. Now you repeat this process for all of the features. So next I'll do the water. So I'll reveal the sketch for water and I'll extrude that up a distance a little higher than I did for the roads. This will make it look better and easier for multicolor printing. One tip is to hide the previous bodies that you created so that you can easily select the thing that you want to extrude. Another tip is to, in the beginning, start by creating components for each feature. I didn't do it at first, but I went back and did it later. It'll make it a lot easier to manage the different bodies when you're trying to keep things all separate and easy for multicolor printing. There's no super easy way for extruding the buildings. If it's a location with a lot of buildings, it can really be quite a pain. I actually eventually gave up on this model just because there was so many buildings, but I promise if you just keep going at it, it won't take too long and you can definitely do it. I'll usually select the buildings kind of in groups and extrude them at different heights just to create more of a real effect. I've used this technique to create cityscapes of different locations in Washington, D.C., the Eiffel Tower in Paris, France, and other flat landscapes, and it's a little bit of a tedious technique, but the results are honestly really satisfying, so I really encourage you to give it a shot and let me know what you think. If you don't want to create these models yourself, but you do want to print them, I'll have most of them available for free on my MakerWorld and Printables account. And if you want to sell the files I've already created, you can subscribe to my Patreon account. All of that will be linked in the description below. Now, terrain maps with elevation. In this technique, we'll use Blender, a free open source 3D modeling software, and BLOSM, a free plugin for Blender that helps you turn publicly available data from OpenStreetMaps into 3D models. This technique is pretty straightforward. If this sounds complex, a good precursor that doesn't require any 3D modeling software is creating terrain maps without the buildings, roads, or grass features. I just made a tutorial on that, and I'll link to it up above. First, download Blender from blender3d.org/download. Now we'll download BLOSM, or Blender for OpenStreetMaps, an awesome plugin created by Procatecture. It has a free version that's totally usable for our purposes. I actually have both the pro and the free version. I'll use the free version in this demo. You can chip in a few dollars if you have the means. I have no affiliation, but do appreciate the creator's work. Just click the link in GitHub, click get, and then click download. This will download a zip file. Don't unzip the zip file. Now go to Blender. Blender can be a little intimidating if it's your first time using it, but just take it slow and you'll get there. Now install the plugin by going to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and then clicking Install. Select the zip file that you just downloaded and click Install Add-on. Search BLOSM in the search bar and then check the box to turn it on. Click the dropdown to open the plugin preferences, and now we'll need to select a folder to store the terrain. Choose any folder that you like on your computer and then click Accept. Now the plugin is installed. Close the preferences. Right-click on the cube in the interface and select Delete. Test the plugin by clicking the chevron in the upper right corner of the screen. Click BLOSM to open the BLOSM plugin interface. Click Import to import the test file. This will preload a map just to make sure the plugin's working as expected. Great, now that we know it's working as expected, let's create a map of our own. Start by creating a new Blender file. Change the units from random Blender units to millimeters by clicking the Scene Properties button, and under Units, change it from 1 to 0.001. You can also switch from meters to millimeters so you don't have to convert in your head. Now to the elevation map with terrain. Go to the BLOSM interface and click Select. This will open up a web browser with the location selection interface. You can search for any location you like in the search bar. I'll search for Mammoth Mountain Ski Resort. Pan around to find the location you want and then click Show Selection Rectangle. Drag the corners of the rectangle to get the exact location you want. Remember, if you haven't done it before, starting small is better. Once you're happy with your selection, click Copy to copy the coordinates. Go back to Blender, and in the BLOSM interface, under the first dropdown, select Terrain. Click Paste to paste the coordinates, and then click Import. This imported the terrain, but it doesn't look like it's there. Click View, and set the N to 10,000 or higher. Now zoom out to see the terrain. Now we'll import the rest of the features. In the BLOSM interface, change terrain to OpenStreetMap. Unselect all of the options except for buildings. Click to import the buildings. They'll import relative to the terrain selection, so they should be on top of the terrain in the right positions. We'll import the rest of the features as 2D, so select 2D, select water objects, forests, vegetation, and roads and paths. Then click import. I found importing the rest of the features as 2D and extruding them later is more likely to end up with a printable model. Now I'll scale the model to be a 3D printable size. click add on the upper left of the screen, mesh, and then plane. I'll set my plane to be 200 millimeters. Then I'll select all of the objects except for the plane. Either select them individually or click A and then command and unselect the plane. Click scale on the left of the screen and drag the circle in to scale the model down until it's approximately the size of the plane. Once it's close, select the move tool and move it down. It doesn't have to be perfect. It'll get corrected in the slicer later. Once you think it looks pretty good, delete the plane. This section on the right is where we can see all of our objects. Let's start converting the 2D objects into 3D. Select all of the 2D objects. Then I'll right click, find convert, and convert to mesh. Now I'll select the grass. On the upper left corner, you'll see we're in object mode. Click the dropdown on the left to switch to edit mode. And then click the fully shaded rectangle to shift to face mode. Click any face, and then click A on your keyboard to select all the faces. Click extrude region on the left, and click the plus to drag the grass upward. I'll extrude the grass up 0.6 millimeters. Similar to the flat cityscapes, I'll extrude each feature a different amount to give it a visual appeal and make it easier for printing. Continue the process by going back to object mode, selecting a feature, going to edit mode, selecting a face, selecting all of the faces, and extruding those faces. Of course, you can do all of the roads at once if you're okay with having them all the same height. Optionally, you can give the building some extra height. Finally, I'll extrude the terrain down. Extrude it down an excessive amount, and we'll chop it off to make a flat plane later in the slicer. I'm sure there's an easier way to do this, but I'm really a novice at Blender, so doing it in the slicer is the easiest way I've found. Now all of the extrusions are done, and our cityscape with terrain is really coming together. Before we're ready to print, we'll need to make sure that it's fully watertight and 3D printable. Go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons to open the Add-ons panel again. This time, type in Tool. Find Mesh 3D Print Toolbox and enable it. Close Preferences, and now you should have the 3D Print Toolbox above or below BLOSM. Now select each feature, check if it's manifold, and if it's not, click Make Manifold. Continue this process for all of the... This 3D Print Toolbox plugin works pretty well, but I have found for complex buildings or sometimes when there's a lot of buildings, trying to make it manifold actually just destroys the building. I'm sure there's other ways to fix this, but I just don't know them. Let me know in the comments if you do. If you run into this issue, you can try importing the buildings individually and just deleting the ones that cause issues. Some buildings might be hanging off the terrain or in some cases even floating. So be sure to check for this, and if it's a problem, just move the buildings down into the terrain. When I exported and tried to slice my terrain map, I found that my roads were too thin. So I selected all the roads in Blender, clicked the gear icon on the right side, clicked Solidify to add a Solidify modifier. I'm not entirely sure how this works, but these settings seem to work pretty well for me. Once everything is manifold, you can use the 3D Print Toolbox plugin to export each feature individually if you're planning on multicolor printing. If you're only printing in one color, you can select all of the features and export them all at once. Select all of the STL files and import them into your slicer as a single object with multiple parts. This will allow you to easily select each feature and assign it a color without having to paint the model. Once you're happy with the colors, cut the model so it's flat for 3D printing. Once the model's cut, it's flat for printing and we have no more errors. This technique is a little bit involved, but once you get the hang of it, you can really create some awesome models. And the results are satisfying. I created this one of the peak in Hong Kong, and creating it really reminded me of my trip there last year. Now, let's print these cityscapes. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to be notified about future videos. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments and I'll do my best to get to them. That's it for today. See you next time.